With the news summary on geo.tv, I'm Sharbana Javeri.
A 28-country-wide tsunami warning has been issued after a huge earthquake measuring 8.9 on the Richter scale hit Indonesia's westernmost province. The quake was felt as far as Singapore, Thailand and India. Chief Meteorologist of Pakistan says Pakistan is not under danger of a tsunami. Rescue workers have created a 450-meter-long access track after digging through 40 feet of snow despite weather hazards. Work on another access track has also begun to widen the search perimeter. Heavy machinery has been deployed at two of the five priority points. Two bulldozers, two earth movers, two dumper trucks and two excavators have been brought in from Islamabad. The three other points are being dug by infantry troops using hand tools and call for assistance of heavy machinery when needed. The government is likely to give a 20% increment to government servants in the upcoming budget. This will be the last budget before the upcoming general elections to be held early next year. According to the recent Asian Development Bank report, the country's energy crisis is the main hurdle in achieving growth targets and is causing constraints for economic growth in Pakistan. The report further adds that the basic structural problems such as precipitous decline in investment, persistently high inflation and security issues are affecting Pakistan's economy. The report claims unless progress can be made in resolving these fundamental problems, the growth outlook will stay modest. Pakistani and Indian businessmen will soon be able to get one-year multiple-entry non-reporting visas, says Pakistani High Commissioner Shahid Malik. In an effort to boost bilateral trade, Pakistan and India are to finalize a new visa agreement to make it easier for certified businessmen to travel. The provision will give one-year multiple-entry visa to those businessmen whose credentials are certified by the chambers on both sides, and the visas will not allow travel to all cities. Malik added that this decision was taken at the meeting between President Asif Ali Zardari and Indian Prime Minister Manmohan Singh on Sunday.